ainsi de Tom, ainsi this is the Rot, and you can see the structure now in this area. Hello YouTube viewers, once again welcome to today's production. This is Free Electricity Channel. Thank you for your comments and also your contribution to this channel for helping to distribute these videos to others. Today I'm going to discuss and also practically show you a very important area which I also believe that will be of benefit to you. For the number of years now, we are talking about free electricity and also serum generator. And today I'm going to look at this aspect
on a very particular area which many of my subscribers have been asking questions about. Some ask, how can they produce a very low cost free energy generator because of their low income? And it is on that basis I started to bring out this production, how to make a low cost free energy generator. What are the ways? What are the instruments? What are the components you need to produce a low cost free energy generator? For instance, this is a good sample of some low cost energy generator. As you can see, take a look at this. You see that this is motor. And in the last few times, I've explained what motor is all about. What motor does. The different functions of motor. I say without the motor, there is no free energy. Because with the motor, free energy is possible. It is the motor that runs the generator, and it is the motor that receives the power source to rotate. And I also explain to you that if you can use your hand crank to turn the generator, you can still have the result of the motor. As long as you can turn at the rotational speed required for the generator to produce the required energy. And after this, we see something like flywheel. I remember I've done production of flywheel and different types of flywheel and their sizes and design. For energy to produce frequently, you have to have a flywheel. The flywheel is the round rotational object that stores the kinetic energy required for the generator. What is the kinetic energy? It's a temporary energy that helps you to switch over from the generator to switch over from the external power supply to the generator. And the flywheel plays a vital role as long as free energy generator is concerned. And after this, we see this is another component. It's also a motor as a supporting motor. Why do we have to have two motor mounted? The reason is for supporting mechanism. When this one motor fails, the others pick up. That is the reason why even in aircraft, there are two engines mounted together. In case if one fails, others can pick up from them. The same thing applicable to displays of free energy generator. One face another carry over. And the motto I've said earlier is the heart or the free energy generator. Now, if you look again, you see some iron constructed around the generator. Why these ions? The ions are the body structure of the engine that mount the generator and the motor. Without the ions, this construction will be incomplete. Then, before you go further, you see a bed. And the bed is the interlink between the generator and the motor and the flywheel. As you can see here, you can see the bed linking the flywheel to the motor. The moment the flywheel turns, the bed automatically rotates. And when the bed rotates, the generator is applied. Very simple. Is this not simple? It is. Now, we see some cables outside. These cables are the output design made to generate this light and supply to the external circuit. Without these two cables, you will not be able to send out voltage as required in the generator system. Now let's take a look at one of the production, and you see low-cost generator is possible. Though it's not completely free, as many may thought that since it's low cost, it should be free. No, it can be free because you have to buy the materials and the construction will be done. So it can be free. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at this fantastic energy system. This is a typical structure, as I've shown you earlier, of the energy. You can see a joint between the generator, between the electric motor and the generator through this joint. Now, take a look and see as well. So fantastic. This is the generator. This is the generator. Now, you can see there's a small bus here. This is a current voltage regulator. Don't be confused about it. It's just a voltage regulator that enables the voltage that's been released when supply from the generator being stored here and listed power source. This is the cable system getting the voltage from the generator supply and running it to this point. As you can see it here, running all to this point. This is the running speed. You can see it's how fast it runs. Let's take back the SD. See the speed ratio of it. Can you see it? Very fast. See the speed ratio of it.